Okay, everybody, welcome back from lunch. And I would like to give Timo Schindler room for his talk about paperless office with open source software. Your stage.
Thank you. So my task is to wake you up after the perfect lunch. Thank you to the organization here. My name is Timo Schindler. Who am I? Timo Schindler. It's actually my first time on a Debian conference, and it's really amazing. Cool people, great stuff. I like it really much. I normally do some sysadmin stuff while work, and when I have free time, I teach, I do blinky stuff, I do soldering stuff. Normally I do stuff like this for kids and also some older kids. So if you like, you can have some. you can reach me Twitter, Mastodon, Mail, or Matrix. I'm also in the IRC here in the Debian conference, so just talk to me. Yeah, I want to introduce you to paperless, paperless next generation, paperless NG. I'm not the developer of this. I'm just really excited about this great tool, and I wanted to show you this tool. So what did I need? I needed some tool for the tax in Germany. You have to do everything. And one time I was printing out a PDF I got, invoice I got as PDF, printed it out and put it in my folder. And I was like, okay, so like 90% of my papers I already get digital. Why do I print them out and put them in a folder? That's crazy. So I've searched something. I asked me, what do I need? So I need a tool to browse PDFs pretty easily. You can do this in the file browser too. So my mic is gone. All right. I needed folders. I love folders. I want to put stuff in some categories. That's why I like folders so much. And optionally, I need some extraction of information, but I didn't need it really much. And also the full text search is pretty nice, would be pretty nice. So I've searched a little bit, found nothing. A friend of mine said, hey, test paperless NG. And then it was like, wow, paperless NG looks great. And at this point, I didn't know how much I needed this tool. That's really cool. What does it do? Paperless is a pretty simple, pretty lightweight web application. That's cool. I like web applications because I can use them everywhere. It's easy PDF browsing, so I can just click, click, click through the PDFs. That was also one main component I needed for this tool, so perfect. And it has tags, so not really folders. At this point, I was like, I want my folders back, but no, just tags. But actually, I realized tags are much better. I explain them later to you. It does OCR, so if you have a scanned PDF, it can tag all text automatically. That's pretty cool. And yeah, full text search, automatic tagging, and email processing. And email processing is like, finally. I didn't know I needed. the insights of the tool. So as I told you, I'm not the developer. I'm not related to the developer. It's from Jonas Winkler. It's a German guy. I like it because he knows how to put invoices and stuff in the right direction. So the tax office is happy about it. It originates from Paperless, from Daniel Quinn and contributors. But Daniel Quinn said he is archiving his Paperless project because Paperless Next Generation is just the best. Just better. And the last version was 1.50 from a few days ago, so it's also the development is on track. Yeah, the backend is Django. The OCR is done by Tesseract. It has a REST API, and the front end is Angular. So no fancy stuff, no Perl. Sorry for Perl developer. I don't like it. So the installation is actually pretty easy. Everything is documented perfectly fine in the documentation. If you can't read this, you get the paper, the slides later on, so you don't have to write something down. It uses Docker, so Jonas encouraged you to use Docker, but and actually I wanted to give you also this hint to use Docker, but here are some great people and they are already trying to package it to, so it will be available in Debian soon, I hope. And I also have to thank Nick and Matilda for the great help, and I hope I will get my first package done in Debian. You can also install it bare metal. Jonas has also an Ansel playbook for you. It's also great, or the, as I told you, the magic, Mechtilde and Nick. So my setup was just a Docker from Docker Hub, a Postgres as database, and Nginx reverse proxy. I've tried it. When you have the right configuration, it's about 10 minutes, and you have a running Docker with paperless and she. So the interface, if you can't read everything here on the left side, that's no worries. I just wanted to show you the overview of the interface. On the left side, there's a menu where you can have some different categories. On the top, the search bar. It searches every document. And also the dashboard is just the landing page with some statistics. And also on the right side, is the first option to upload things. So you can just use the web interface to upload your documents, but you can also have a lot more. I'm into that later. On the right side, you have a zoom in to the menu. On the top, you have the dashboard, just the starting page. The second point is documents. That's where all your documents are stored. That's where you can all search all your documents. That's where you can search all tags and everything. And then some special categories are there. The correspondence, tags, and document types are just three types of the document where you can use as filter, search for it, categorize your documents. Log settings and admin is just administration stuff. If you want to see where in the process is your document right now, you can look in the logs or get some users, new users in the admin setting, in the admin panel, or do some settings. Xaver is not here, but he the first question he had, does it have dark view? Yes, it has. So document types is the main category, more or less. There you can have different types of the document. Invoice, for example, what would be another? A manual, if you have manuals in there. Contracts, if you want to store contracts in there. This is just the main type of the document. And the cool thing about these types is you can choose a name. You can choose a matching pattern the down here on the left side. And the matching algorithm, I've showed you all the matching algorithms on the right side. It's pretty cool. It's actually the best thing. You use any, then it just searches the document for this particular word or any of the words you're describing in the matching pattern. Or you can also use some fancy stuff like auto. It has a machine learning algorithm where you can categorize your documents automatically. I haven't too much experience with this, but it works, I've heard. But you also can use regular expressions if you like them more, or fuzzy, which is also pretty cool. Then it doesn't have to say invoice, it can also say invoices or something else or something similar to it. The tags, these are the much better versions of my beloved folders. They are like folders, but better. Because you can have several tags to a single document. That's pretty cool. You can just print out your document two or three times and put it in different folders or directories or store it in different folders, but actually you don't want to multiply your document. You want just one document which stores all the information and tag it as you like. For the text, there are some more options. You can choose a color. You can choose a random color with this dice here on the right side. Also pretty cool. I don't want to have a special color. I want just any color. And the inbox tag. I explained this later to you. And the inbox tag is pretty cool. You can add this to every document you import into paperless. For example, if you extract your documents from email, you want to store it first, or you'd want to tag it with a to-do that you have to look over it if the information got extracted correctly, or if you want to add some more tags to it. So to-do is a pretty good tag, first tag. And for sure, you also have a matching algorithm and a matching pattern. The correspondent is just the person, institute, company that the document either originates from or is sent to. So this is a sentence just from the documentation. The documentation is also that good that it shows you the normal process, how to process your documents. Okay, and now you have all these tags and categories and stuff, but most of the times you have one particular filter setting, like I want my invoices, my private invoices, two tags, I want to filter for it, and then want to save this filter or this view. You can also do this, and that's neat because then you can personalize your paperless. And they also show in the get shown in the left side saved views and in the dashboard. And now the dashboard is empty when you put documents in there. The last added documents are also in the view. Yeah, great for to-dos, different areas of your life, like this company I have and my private stuff. I want to store everything in there. Okay. So when you add documents, or which ways can you add documents, you can just use the dashboard. I showed it to you already. You can have a consumption directory. This is actually the main way to get documents in your paperless. So it's just a folder on a server or on your machine or somewhere where you put in some PDFs or documents or whatever, and paperless has a loop and loops through this folder and takes out every document added in there. It has a email interface where it can just get the documents from your emails. Mobile upload, so there are some mobile apps and a REST API if you want to make your own stuff. What is happening? So paperless gets the PDF, for example. If it is not already text, it does OCR to it. So OCR scans the document and detects the text in it. It will create an archive-able PDF-A document. This is pretty cool for storing the documents for longer times. PDF-A is just, so you can store your document like 20 or 30 years. I don't know exactly. It's a special standard. With no fancy stuff, just the PDF. It will then make this automatic matching of the tags and the correspondence and types, and afterwards stores it on the server or in the folder you decide, and it stores the PDFA alongside with your original document, so the original document does not get any OCR over it, it's just the original document. This is also pretty cool. Yeah, the overall workflow, also from the documentation, you get a feeling for it that this is a German guy. I also like this kind of stuff. So you start and you have this document in front of you. Do I want to keep this copy? For example, for invoice, I have to store it. Do I have a contract? Yes, I want this paper contract still. But is it some manual, for example? I don't want to keep it. So I scan it. If I want to keep it, I write an archive serial number on it. Also some function which is provided by paperless. Then you scan the document and it gets archived. If you don't want to store the scanned document, you can just throw it away. Then the tagging is performed and you remove the inbox tag, and that's all. This is the document view. There you can see where the tags are listed. So you have these different documents here. For example, the first document is documentation about PDFA. It's in to-do, private, and in 2020. There is a Atmel, what is it, a data sheet. I've stored it in data sheet 2020, and this is for business stuff. And on the left side is an invoice. It's still in the to-do. I have to tag it later. You can search directly also stuff which is just in the document. For example, this is a invoice for a watch. You can just search for the watch and get the invoice about it. That's pretty cool. I'm at the end. So my conclusion, did I get everything what I needed with this tool? Yes. That's actually provided me some more stuff I didn't know I needed. That's the next part. I did find some really cool stuff there. I'm just missing a little bit about this tax stuff. I'm using paperless for the main task. For example, automatic extraction of the price of the invoice. This is needed for tax, but when I think about it, paperless is not the tool for this. I have to add some features or some additional tool to it to help me there, but paperless does already all the work. My only concern is that this development is just done by one main developer. He does 99% of all the work. So if you're interested in the tool, if you like the tool, show them some love and help to Jonas Winkler on GitHub. I think he will like it. Normally this talk was created with a hands-on, so I've provided also a test installation for you. You can just log in with these credentials to test.bluit.de, and you can also find the slides here. Later on today at 20:30 in car 002, at beer o'clock, you will find me there, and we can have a hands-on, upload some test PDFs, and I show you every feature, and we can have some Q&A on it. So thank you very much. If you have any questions, please just let me know, or please just let the microphone know where you are. Thank you.
Yes, thank you for your talk. Are there any questions from the audience?
So, my mission failed, you're not awake. Oh, there's one question.
Yes, hi, thanks for the talk. I'm just wondering about the storage of the documents. So, you said something about Postgres, but on the other side, you said you can also store it on the folder. So I'm just...
So the Postgres just stores all the meta information and the extracted text. The text will be stored alongside with the PDF. And the OCR PDF, or the text which was found in the PDF, is also stored in this PDFA. It's just for storage, for long-time purpose. All the search in the tool will be done in the database. Yeah, and the folders is pretty neat. You can also, it's not just 001 PDF, 002 PDF or something like that. You can have human readable PDFs in different folders. So it takes the main tag and puts it in the folder, and does also the organization for you in the folders. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, that's what I was wondering about, because if maybe sometime the tool is down, do I have still access in a decent way to the files?
That's a good point. You don't need this tool to access your files. They are just stored on the file system, not in any database, no, nothing. It's just a PDF, or just the thing you upload is stored there. So here. Yeah.
On your local machine or on your remote machine?
Depends where you install it. So it installs it where it stores it where you install it. If you want to have it on your local machine, then you have to move the folder to your local machine. It needs the folder.
Can you use the API to sync a local folder with the remote?
Probably
because
yes.
That would be pretty nice.
Yeah, I think it would be better if you use SSHFS or something like that to get the folder, the remote folder on your local machine. I think this is the best way. He also describes it. He just tells you,
Or just use the folder as a Git repository, for example.
For example.
So you can sync it as well.
Yeah, for example.
Any more questions?
Some questions in the stream? No stream questions? Okay. Hello to the stream.
Okay, so thank you again for your talk and last applause for you.
Okay. Thank you.